40 years ago today, Americans were fighting in Vietnam. Watergate was just a bungled burglary, and the Supreme Court legalized abortion. It's that landmark case, Roe v. Wade, that still divides and inflames nearly two generations later. Millions of Americans choose opposite sides of this argument, legal rights versus moral wrongs. And those divisions haven't changed much since 1973. According to a new poll from NBC and the Wall Street Journal, a majority of Americans for the first time want abortion to be legal in most or all cases. 54% in all feel that way. 35% say abortion should be legal only in cases of rape, incest, and to save the mother's life. 9% say illegal without exceptions. Legalizing abortion is one of the biggest single issues to shape American culture, both legally and politically. Our crime and justice correspondent Joe Johns is in Washington with more. And do you think the U.S. Supreme Court will actually revisit Roe v. Wade anytime soon?
Carol, you know, justices can only take up the cases that come their way, in other words, through the court. So the first thing that has to happen is the right case has to come to them. And right now, anti-abortion activists can do the math. You've got a shaky 5-4 conservative majority on the court. It doesn't really inspire confidence that Roe would be overturned if the issue were taken up right now. In fact, there's a risk, and that risk is upholding Roe in the 21st century would effectively end the debate for decades to come. It's power of precedent at the court. So instead of attacking Roe head on, the opponents essentially have been doing what they've been doing for years, chipping away at its impact. They support some restrictions on abortion that don't go to the heart of the case, things like government funding, parental consent, bans on later term abortions, and so on, Carol.
Joe Johns reporting live from Washington this morning. Our next guest is involved in the debate as an abortion rights activist. Nancy Keenan is president of NARAL Pro-Choice America. She joins us now from Washington. Nancy, welcome.
Well, great to be here, Carol. Thank you.
You know, it's interesting. You wanted us to refer to your organization as Pro-Choice America, and I have read countless articles that your movement doesn't like the term pro-choice any longer.
Well, you know, pro-choice America is what this country reflects. People in the country that don't believe that politicians belong in this decision, that it's between a woman, a doctor, and her God, and that the bureaucrats, the politicians should stay out of it. And here we are, 40 years later, making sure that that right and freedom remains for women across the country.
Some abortion rights activists say that pro-choice seems to, like, say you either choose between life and death, and that's why they don't like the term.
You know, a term is a term. I think the issue here is who makes the decision, who decides. And there are some on the anti-choice side that say that government should make the decision, a politician should make the decision, and not a woman and her doctor and her family. And so the terms can be something that is debated one way or another. Fundamentally, we believe in the right and the privacy of women to make these decisions, and not the politicians that either sit in the state house or here in Washington, D.C.
A recent cover of Time magazine says 40 years ago, abortion rights activists won an epic victory in Roe v. Wade. They've been losing ever since. And, you know, Joe Johns mentioned it, that slow chipping away at the decision in state legislatures across America. What's your take?
Well, I think the issue is not that it's legal anymore. Roe remains, that abortion is legal in this country. The question becomes access. And what the other side has been effective in doing is denying women access by throwing barriers up. But when we see when the people have a chance to vote, example is in Mississippi on the personhood amendment, they said, no, enough, we reject that. They rejected an outright ban in South Dakota twice. And so when the people actually have a chance to put that ballot in the box, they reject this kind of anti-choice activity. Now, elections matter. And you have to elect politicians that protect that right and that freedom, and not the folks, quite honestly, like the Todd Akins who showed up here and don't even understand how a woman's body works, let alone him making a decision for women across this country.
Well, you have to admit that his comments, his unfortunate comments, have kind of fueled your movement, a movement that, you know, young women, I think there was a poll out that women under 30 have no idea what Roe v. Wade is. They have no idea. So Todd Akins sort of introduced that, so he sort of did the work for you.
Well, not necessarily. We fought so that our daughters and our granddaughters wouldn't have to worry about this issue. But what we learned in a Todd Akin and anti-choice politicians is that you forever have to be vigilant, that they never stop, they don't give up until they deny women this basic freedom in this country. So, yes, the younger generation, they are working in this movement, they are fighting, and the fact of the matter is we have to be vigilant, and the other side is never going to give up until they take this right away from women all over this country.
Nancy Keenan, president of NARAL Pro-Choice America, thank you so much for being with us this morning.
My pleasure. Thank you.